The beast is down there.
No, no.
She knows the beast is down there. Why does she keep going towards
him? He's always
watching you.
The beast is there. You're never safe from him.
You can feel it.
Be careful.
She needs to find him.
Where is he?
She's found it. She's lost it and she has to find it. Feel it.
Where is it?
The torch alight.
Up.
You're never going to find it.
Are you even going the right way?
Thank you.
she wouldn't listen.
He was doing his best.
She never, ever listened.
Didn't she listen to him? Trying to help her.
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zimbel was right.
Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't listen.
She never disappeared.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her.
It's all her fault.
All her fault. She's weak. She should have known. She should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn?
Before she learns. She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never find it.
She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless evil.
Sigurd learned that Grimhild had once disobeyed Odin, and so he had her punished, stuck her with a sleep thorn, and put her body within a rampart of burning shields. Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless, and passes through the flames, just as I did, and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and help, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes, to fight amongst the gods in hell.
Where's the moon?
She was never here.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
What's she doing?
She's lighting a torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking? How's she going to get there?
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death. And every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Thank you. of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rayan also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Torch will go out.
The beast.
Yeah.
Didion.
Go quick, Hurst.
Keep the torch alive.
Up. Keep the torch up. I'm coming!